Good morning, YZetta. Today is March 2nd. I'm Joe Kotke.
And I'm Deanna Giles. Let's get started. There is a new badminton team that's being started by WHS students. There's an informational meeting on Tuesday, March 7th at 3:30 in A204.
Club YES members interested in applying for the 2017 to 2018 Club YES Leadership Board should pick up an application at the Club YES office. The application deadline is Tuesday, March 28th.
Take a trip to Quebec City in Canada this summer. The French department is sponsoring the trip. For more information, see Ms. Berg in A414.
The next driver ed classroom will be in April. Get registered now so you aren't disappointed when classes fill up. Floor offices have flyers with more information about dates, times, and location, as well as cost and how to register.
Hey, YZetta, are you interested in learning more about NDSU? The rep from North Dakota State University will be there today at 12:20. Stop by the CCC to get a pass for this visit.
Hey, Deanna, did you go to the game last night?
I did. It was very intense.
Yeah, it was a good one. Big upset. Boys hockey picks up an absolutely monumental victory last night over the Edina Hornets to capture the section title 3-1. The Hornets were ranked number 2 in the state going into sections, and by defeating them, the Trojans earned a ticket to the state tournament. This victory came as quite a shot given the Trojans' 7-17 regular season record, but now they're 3-0 in the playoffs, and that's all that matters in a Cinderella story. Junior Griffin Ness had 2 goals on the night, one being an empty netter to put the game away. That said, the most valuable player of the night was undoubtedly senior goaltender Reed Wyshenko, who came alive with 29 saves on the night. Girls basketball had their section quarterfinals last night against Minneapolis Southwest and absolutely dominated the competition, 54-16. This moves the girls on to the section semifinals next week. Boys swim and dive will travel down to the U of M Aquatic Center tonight and throughout the weekend to battle for a state title. Good luck to the boys. And finally, boys basketball will play against the Edina Hornets tomorrow night here at YZetta High School. The Hornets handed the Trojans their first loss of the season, and this will be the final regular season game before the section tournament begins. Now she's having a happy, happy birthday.
Thursday, March 16th from 6 to 8 p.m. in the lower commons of the cafeteria. Register for a free scannable barcode so you don't have to fill out an information card at the fair. Check your school email for details. If you have any questions, please see Mrs. Mustard in the CCC.
Trojan Leadership Council members, remember you have a new meeting time, so please come Friday, March 3rd at 7:45 a.m. in the Media Center classroom.
Freshmen, please check your email and complete the Respect Retreat survey before next Monday, March 6th.
Due to conferences, the OT will be closed after school today. We will reopen on Monday, March 6th.
On March 6th, there will be a selective college night hosting reps from Northwestern, MIT, McAllister, Notre Dame, and Boston College. This free event will be held from 7 to 8 p.m. in the auditorium, too. No registration is needed, and parents are welcome to attend. Now let's go over to A&E with Kai.
Hello, YZetta, and welcome back to your weekly A&E News. I'm Kai Christensen, and let's get started. Thank you to everyone who auditioned for the spring play, The Sparrow. The callback list will be posted by 3:10 today, and callbacks will take place tomorrow after school in the second auditorium. Packets can be picked up at the drama board. The Minneapolis Institute of Arts has a new exhibit opening Sunday, March 5th and continuing to May 28th. The exhibit is titled At Home with Monsters, and it takes a look into the inspirations and creative process for Spanish filmmaker Guillermo del Toro. Tickets are $20 and free for students. Films getting a wide release this weekend are Logan, the new Marvel film about the Wolverine, and Before I Fall, a Groundhog Day type movie for the younger generation. That's all for A&E, and now back to the studio.
Thanks, Kai, for that update. So, what we got next?
Well, we're going to go learn about Day of Silence, I think. Do you know when that is?
I'm not sure, but we will learn about it in this preview.
The Day of Silence is a day that recognizes the harassment that goes on towards students in the LGBT community.
We need the Day of Silence because there has been a lot of LGBT youth who has been silenced either through bullying or their home life or through your suicide.
This is important to me because me and a lot of my friends are a part of the LGBT community, and I hate how we're always being criticized for who we are.
This is important to me because people who have been silenced need to be remembered.
The biggest problem isn't acceptance, I would say it's lack of understanding, because if you understand the situation, then it's much easier to accept someone for who they are.
You can talk to your friends or whoever you need be that are LGBT students and just say, I'm here for you, ask questions, be that support, and just offer to be there for them when they need to be.
I'm going to be silent for people who constantly live a lie in their life because of fear of other people.
I'm going to be silent for, personally, all the trans youth who have committed suicide in the last few years.
I'm silent for the students that don't have anybody to be silent for them.
I'm going to be silent for a friend that's family didn't accept him for who he was, and it cost him his life.
So guys, we haven't had a news break for a while.
Yeah, that overcoming challenges video was pretty powerful.
I know, I enjoyed it. So what's for news, Quinn?
Oh, we got a lot today. According to CNN, the FBI is investigating a possible hate crime that took place yesterday evening in Kansas. Two men, Alak Manasani and Srinivas Kuchbala, went to a local bar for a drink after work when a man approached them and questioned their citizenship. The men explained that they had work visas, and the men begrudgingly left, only to return a short time later with a gun. Kuchbala was killed by the gunman, and Manasani was injured along with another bar patron. The shooter was arrested later that night and has been charged with first-degree murder and attempted murder. According to CNN, the two accountants responsible for the Oscar fiasco, now dubbed Envelope Gate, has been banned from the award show. The accountants will keep their jobs with the PricewaterhouseCoopers, but new accountants will be managing the Academy's business from now on. A Minneapolis high school closed yesterday afternoon due to a threat from a student. According to GoMN News, De La Salle High School issued an online school day after a student posted a long threat on social media along with pictures of a gun. School administrators said they have identified the students who were posted the threat and that the student will come back to school after investigation from the district. From the YZ technical crew, on behalf of Kai Christensen and Trip Lavely, I'm Quinn Maliso.
I'm Joe Kotke.
And I'm Deanna Giles. Have an awesome Thursday. Don't need drive slow, but